this video, we want to share a handful of practices that have helped us a lot with our own scanning. 1. We cut off the corner with a staple. This is a very quick way to get rid of the staples. 2. We scan batches of 5 or 10 exams in one go. This reduces the overhead in starting the scanner and saving scans to disk. 3. We always make sure to know how many pages the scanner is supposed to have scanned. This is done most easily by always scanning the same number of exams and by keeping any exams with an irregular number of pages separate and scan those last. When the scan is complete, we check whether the correct number of pages was scanned. For example, here the scanning software reports 30 pages have been scanned, which in this case means every page was scanned. It rarely happens with modern scanners, but in case something went wrong during scanning, it's much easier to rescan right away than to find out later and have to dig through the exams to find that specific exam that needs to be rescanned. 4. We restaple the exams after they come out of the scanner. This helps us if, for some reason, we'd ever want to look at the paper exams. 5. We always scan double-sided. Students might write something on the back, and we want to make sure to have it all captured in our scans. 6. Since we have to scan double-sided to not lose anything, we might as well have exams that are printed double-sided. This halves the number of sheets that have to be passed through the scanner, and accordingly cuts scanning time in half compared to single-sided exams. 7. Here are our findings about scanner settings. 150 dpi is plenty, and often faster than higher resolution. Since Gradescope expects consistency across exams, we ensure to disable auto-rotation of pages and to disable automatic blank page removal. Here are the settings we use for our own ScanSnap iX500.